Also, we got it back and we want to keep it and continue the tradition.
Apple Valley takes to the field in high-energy manner, fueled by the biggest home crowd in recent memory. Victor Valley enters the stadium with a bold, calculated swagger, brimming with confidence. It is to be a bell game to remember. The Sun Devils scored on their first play from scrimmage. Ben Quiroz hits Kavion Flournoy on a crossing pattern, and the 6'1 senior takes it 64 yards. The Jackrabbits immediately took the wind from the Sun Devils' sails. Third and 16, deep in their own territory, Zeke Julian connects with Trevon Bedard for 81 yards. On the next play, Jordan Watson drives in from 2 yards out. The Sun Devils respond with a scoring drive capped by Jermaine Lowe's 16-yard run. It's Apple Valley 14, Victor Valley 10 to end the first quarter. In the second quarter, Jackrabbits special teams make two huge plays. Apple Valley tries a field goal from long distance, but the play backfires. Zeke Julian takes the kick inside the five and zigzags his way 98 yards to put the Rabbits on top for the first time in this 42nd battle for the bell. When the Rabbits' defense holds Apple Valley on the next possession, Victor Valley appears to have the momentum. But 6'3", 255-pound Kyle Jerkins pounces on the loose ball, and the Sun Devils are back in business. The junior quarterback, Quiroz, scrambles in from 6 out, and the Sun Devils are back on top, 21-17, with 30 seconds to go before the half. Here's the second of the two special teams, special plays that virtually make the difference in the ball game. Apple Valley kicks away from Isaiah Kepley, but that doesn't cut it if kick coverage collapses. Travion Bedard breaks two tackles and runs the kickoff back 98 yards for a touchdown. And it was Bedard again, scoring the fourth Victor Valley touchdown, the 21-yard scoring play from Zeke Julian. The Victor Valley lead is 10 in the third quarter. The Jackrabbits hold on. The final, 38-30.
How was the difference in this game tonight?
I think we wanted it more than them. Last year we got it back and we want to keep it and continue the tradition. All the seniors wanted it. The line did a great job. Everybody did their part and we got it back.
Pandemonium prevails, predictable, epitomizing school spirit. High school rivals football. Apple Valley regains the bell. And it's largely because Victor Valley could not contain Sun Devils running back Tyler Murphy. The 5'8", 155-pound junior rushed for 297 yards. This TD, the first of the game, from 23 yards. The Jackrabbits responded immediately and convincingly. Alberto Rivera sidesteps one tackler, then covers the 20-yard to pay dirt untouched. It's 6-6. And one can but wonder how the course of this game may have changed had it not been for the Jackrabbits' misfortune on this play. Dante Hicks is stripped of the ball by Jacob Munoz after a huge game deep into Sun Devils territory. It's Damon Ambers with the recovery, and Victor Valley never seems to recover. The Rabbits do not cross into Sun Devils territory the rest of the night. Apple Valley scores 24 points in the second quarter, and the Sun Devils never look back. It was a night of near-perfect execution for senior quarterback Ben Quiroz. This is the second Sun Devils touchdown. Roman Novell, all alone, on the 32-yard scoring play. First of two scoring passes to the 5'10 senior receiver. The second from 14 yards out. Quiroz connects with Tyler Baskett, who gets behind the Jackrabbits corner for this 21-yard scoring play. Quiroz on the night, 7 of 11 for 112 yards in the air and 3 touchdown passes. But the night was a greater showcase for Tyler Murphy before a crowd of 5,000 plus. 6 of his 34 carries for gains of 15 yards or more. Murphy follows the path plowed by the likes of 59 Anthony Ballinger, 56 Jacob Tizard, 61 Matthew Hajazin, and 68 Troy Bacon. Murphy capped off his incredible performance with a 6-yard touchdown in the third quarter. In 3 games, Murphy has rushed for 671 yards. The Sun Devils' defense was dominant. Tyler Bernal falls on the loose ball on this jackrabbit turnover. Bernal, number 70, the 5'11", 180-pound junior. Jacob Munoz picks off the Daniel Walker aerial. Munoz, one of 5 sophomores starting for Coach Frank Felice's Sun Devils. Another super soft linebacker, Mason Kelly, number 43. Kelly was the team's leading tackler in the opening game win over Barstow. With their quickness, aggressiveness off the ball, and pursuit to the ball, an opponent pays dearly for missing an offensive assignment. Defensively, the Devils do not impress you with their size. What they may lack in bulk, though, they make up for in quickness, toughness, and overall team speed. Number 7 is senior linebacker Anthony Barbich. The final score, 51-6. The 45-point margin of victory equals that of the Sun Devils' 58-13 blowout 12 years ago. Just how good is this Sun Devils team? That question to be answered in large part in 2 weeks when Apple Valley takes on Serrano. The Mojave River League title at stake in greater likelihood in the league opener for both teams. But on this night, for the Sun Devils, the seniors in particular, an emotional mission accomplished in regaining the bell.
Well, the significance is we've been waiting for this for the past 2 years because we lost it. And finally, we're seniors, we wanted it back, we worked hard for it, we got it.
Sun Devils standout running back Tyler Murphy leads Apple Valley to a 20-12 victory in Bellgame 44. The senior running back rushes for 217 yards, including a 69-yard touchdown. This long jaunt comes 8 minutes into the first quarter and puts Apple Valley ahead to stay. Murphy's ball-carrying heroics give him over 500 yards rushing in his 2 Bell games. He carried for 297 yards against the crosstown rivals his junior season. This night's 217 yards come on 17 carry. Ultra-talented and ever so humble, Murphy gives all the credit to his offensive line.
Okay, you know, my line did everything. Everybody blocked super great. There's huge holes on that. I just gotta give it up to my line.
Naeem Thomas spearheads Apple Valley's defense with a pass interception and a fumble recovery.
And he dove for it and he tipped it and went up, and I just dove right at the last minute and came up with it.
Come on, recovery also.
Yes, sir. Same thing. It was a very intense game. Got a game when the chance is good.
The Jackrabbits score on their first possession. Sophomore Josh Woods capping the 80-yard drive, scoring from 9 yards out. A botched extra point attempt leaves the score at 6-0. Sophomore quarterback Eric Turner scores the second Victor Valley touchdown, a 2-yard run in the fourth, pulling within one at 13-12. But again, the Sun Devils thwart the extra point attempt. This earlier field goal attempt is blocked by Jacob Munoz as Apple Valley special teams turn in game-changing plays. The blocked field goal leads to Apple Valley extending the lead on their own field goal in the first quarter. A fourth quarter Justin Connor touchdown pass to Brian Fuentes clinches the Sun Devils' win, making it 2 straight. In what becomes their historic string of consecutive Bell Game victories. Bell Game 2013, Bell Game number 45, and one of the most exciting down to the last series, down to the wire, or perhaps up to the belfry, contests in the history of the crosstown rivalry between Victor Valley's Jackrabbits and the Apple Valley Sun Devils. Apple Valley's D'Angelo Guillory scored the winning touchdown with 4.5 minutes remaining in the ballgame in the Sun Devils' 13-6 victory. But that touchdown, Guillory's second of the night, was far from the last big play of the game. Not even Guillory's last big play of the night. Apple Valley appeared to be about to put the game away when Tevin James pounced on the bad snap from center in Rabbits punt formation. Apple Valley first down on the Victor Valley 10. But 3 plays later, another center of attention, this time Apple Valley's. The high snap recovered by the Jackrabbits, Joseph Vidio. And with 2 minutes remaining, Victor Valley in position to drive for a game-tying touchdown. Backing it up and setting the stage for the fourth quarter drama, the teams played to a scoreless tie the first half. Apple Valley's defense turned in 2 huge plays, at least they appeared to be at the time, pass interceptions, the first by Jacob Munoz, the second, Justin Wagner. But on both occasions, the Jackrabbit defense, combined with a mistake-prone Sun Devils offense, kept the visitors from across the narrows out of the end zone. Apple Valley came out roaring the second half. Joy Bingham, number 66, recovering the fumble on Victor Valley's first play from scrimmage in the third quarter. A 13-yard Justin Connors to Mason Kelly connection takes the ball to the 1. D'Angelo Guillory reaches the end zone, or at least reaches out and gets the football across the goal line, and the first points of the game are scored 90 seconds into the third. Victor Valley blocks the extra point attempt, and it's 6-0 Sun Devils. Apple Valley's next possession, a deep drive into the red zone, 4th and 1. Victor Valley's 320-pound Gabriel Razzo nearly bears all in coming up with the huge stop. That sets up a 94-yard scoring drive beginning late in the third. Victor Valley, on the first play of the fourth quarter, Daniel Walker rifles the 8-yard strike to Joseph Badillo, and the Rabbits are in position to take the lead. But their extra point kick is no good, and the score remains tied at 6. Victor Valley missed another opportunity to take the lead, missing on a 31-yard field goal attempt at the midway mark in the fourth. But while the offense faltered, the defense didn't. Sean Delatorre with the fumble recovery. Apple Valley's game-deciding 80-yard drive began following the errant field goal attempt by the Rabbits. This third down pass completion, Justin Connors to Dwight Williams, crucial in keeping that drive alive. Guillory gets the call and crosses the goal on the play from a yard out. Sam Wallace's kick follows, and Apple Valley's lead is 7. 4:35 remains in the game. The crazy exchange of bad snap from center turnovers by both teams followed. And now we are to the Jackrabbits' final drive. Victor Valley quarterback Daniel Walker led the final Rabbits drive, Walker to Jamal Tate. Walker to Tate, to Donald Mitchell into Sun Devils territory. It took this, the Angelo Guillory pass interception with under a minute remaining to finally put the game away. The final, Apple Valley 13, Victor Valley 6.
Senior running back Tristan McNatt powered, plowed, bulled, and barreled his way over Victor Valley defenders in leading the Sun Devils to a 35-28 victory in the battle for the Bell. The 47th annual Bell game, featured by the Great American Rivalry series, which shines the spotlight on top high school football rivalries across the nation. Tristan McNatt scored 2 touchdowns and rushed for 109 yards and was named Most Valuable Player by the Great American Rivalry Series. The battle for the Bell was a classic struggle between 2 long-standing rivals played before a near-capacity crowd of high-energy fans, both sides of Raymore Stadium. This is the 5th Bell game in the last 7 decided by a touchdown or less. Apple Valley's triumph tied the mark for 1 school recording 5 consecutive Bell game victories. After falling behind 21-7 in the second quarter, Apple Valley came back behind a balanced offensive attack that marked a breakthrough game for junior quarterback Mossy Bell. It was Bell's touchdown pass to Kai Merchant that brought Apple Valley to within 7 at halftime. And another Mossy Bell to Kai Merchant touchdown pass puts the Sun Devils ahead to stay in the third quarter. Mossy Bell's effective passing was opened up by the thunder and lightning ground game of seniors Greg Sprague and Tristan McNatt. Time and time again, the senior running backs displayed second effort in breaking tackles, keeping drives alive, and finally enabling the Sun Devils to run out the clock after Victor Valley had pulled within 7 late in the fourth quarter. Greg Sprague carried for 239 yards and scored the first Sun Devils touchdown, a 9-yard power burst that tied the score at 7 in the first quarter. Apple Valley overcame a tremendous game from Jackrabbit quarterback Justin Ortiz, who completed 15 of 25 passes for 308 yards and 4 touchdowns. Victor Valley scored on their opening possession, Justin Ortiz to Elijah Whitfield on a 9-yard play. Justin Ortiz lofts the pass to Andy Garcia, who reaches high ahead of Devils free safety Seth Baker coming over the top. Garcia backs into the end zone. The Jackrabbits are back within a touchdown. Apple Valley runs out the clock. First-year coach Matt Rohrbaugh has his first Bell game victory at the helm.
Yes, it was amazing. You know what I mean? That's what Bell games are all about.
The final score, Apple Valley 35, Victor Valley 28.
The dazzling pass reception by T.J. Lewis gives Apple Valley the winning touchdown in the 48th, battle for the Bell. The scoring pass from Mossy Bell with 5 minutes remaining in the fourth quarter. The Sun Devils' defense then denies the Jackrabbits a 4th and goal at the 2 to hold on for the 29-22 Bell game victory. The Jackrabbits had taken the lead on Justin Ortiz's 15-yard touchdown pass to Desmond Kepley at the 3-minute mark in the third quarter. The Sun Devils' successful conversion following the T.J. Lewis TD reception, Seth Baker diving into the end zone, gives Apple Valley their final 2 points, and the Sun Devils become the first team to win 6 consecutive Battle for the Bell games in the Great American Rivalry Series.
Man, it's really a feeling you can't explain. You know, like all these people here,
Bell game, you know, adrenaline's pumping, you know.
This 2016 Bell game marked the first time in the 48-year series that the Sun Devils and Jackrabbits both enter the Cross Valley rivalry undefeated. The Sun Devils take the field before a standing room only crowd upward of 5,000 in attendance across the sidelines. What does the Jackrabbits' first-year coach hope to see from his team?
All I hope for is that they play together, that they're united, and they just stick together regardless of what happens. Good or bad, just want them to stick together.
I hope to see just enthusiasm, physical football, and just flying around, making big plays tonight.
The Sun Devils began flying around and making big plays from the start. Charles Logan takes the opening kickoff at the 14, bobbles it momentarily, retrieves the ball, and races 86 yards past the Jackrabbit sidelines. Apple Valley takes the lead on the first play of the game. 13 seconds in, unlucky for Victor Valley, 7-0 Apple Valley. Ethan Smith's kick from 29 yards out gives the Sun Devils a 10-0 lead with 41 seconds remaining in the first quarter. The Jackrabbits begin the long march back. Justin Ortiz to Gabriel Trujillo all the way down inside the red zone to the 15. Next play, Justin Ortiz to Gabriel Trujillo, and the Jackrabbits are on the board. And Ortiz to Andy Garcia, two-point conversion pulls Victor Valley within 10. 18-8. The Rabbits insert massive lineman Hinzel Fotofili, 10, 280 pounds. Reference the refrigerator of Da Bears fame. Hinzel Fotofili plows over from 2 yards out, and it's a three-point game. Sun Devils 18, Jackrabbits 15. Apple Valley adds a 37-yard field goal with time running out in the second quarter to make it 21-15. With 3:22 to play in the third. Third and 10 from the 15. Justin Ortiz beats the pass rush and lofts it to 6'2 senior Damian Kepley, who's glided behind a pair of defenders and pulls down the scoring pass. The extra point gives Victor Valley the lead, 22-21. Mossy Bell rolls to his right. Devin Fisher, 57, picks off stunting linebacker Jaime Campos. T.J. Lewis turns on the stop-and-go route, grabs the ball, loses the handle, regains control, and turns the play into Bell game history. The final, Apple Valley 29, Victor Valley 22. It goes down as one of the most exciting games in Battle for the Bell history. In addition to 6 straight, it is 11 wins in the last 13 Bell games for the Sun Devils. The Apple Valley Sun Devils scored twice in 16 seconds in the third quarter, en route to a 57-12 Bell game victory over Victor Valley. Kishon Griffin's kickoff return for a touchdown, followed by Seth Baker's interception and 75-yard return, putting the game well out of reach in the 49th edition of the Battle for the Bell. The Sun Devils score the first 3 times they get their hands on the ball to open the contest. Donovan Ferguson breaks the ice on a 10-yard run. Jeff Widener's 6-yard touchdown pass to tight end Kai Merchant, the Sun Devils' second possession. Donovan Williams' 65-yard run makes it a 3-touchdown lead, 21-0, early in the second quarter. 14 seconds to go before halftime. Jeff Widener lofts the touchdown pass to Kashawn Griffin on the 28-yard scoring play that makes it 28-0 at the intermission. Jeff Widener also has a 17-yard scoring pass to Xander Witt. The final touchdown of the game comes on the 3rd touchdown of the night by Kashawn Griffin. Late game razzle-dazzle on the wide receiver reverse. In the early going, Victor Valley held down the high-scoring Sun Devils by holding onto the ball, consuming huge chunks of first and second quarter time of possession. But the Sun Devils' Jake Anderson makes this major impact play, blocking the Jackrabbits' punt, picking it up, and running it down to the 6 to set up Apple Valley's second touchdown. The eventual 57-12 win is Apple Valley's 7th consecutive Bell game victory.
The Community Table Restaurant Online Sports Report. Action highlights brought to you by the Community Table Restaurant in the Holiday Inn in Victorville, supporting Victor Valley teams and athletic programs. Terry Kurtz here, throwing you an invitation to catch the 30-minute action highlights program, your High Desert Sports Report, showing daily on the Victor Valley Television Network, victorvalleytv.com.